Student in this CET lecture. So in this lecture we are going to revise a new topic or the subunit from the sexual reproduction in angiosperm. In that we are going to revise today the three aspects of the post-fertilization changes. The first one, the development of endosperm, and it is followed by how the ovule is converted into seed, and the third aspect, it is the development of the fruit and the structure of the simple fruit. So now we revise this. Student, now we are going to study the endosperm development in angiosperm. Okay, so you know that from which cell the endosperm development begins? After fertilization, when there is a development of the triploid cell. Okay, triploid cell. What is that triploid cell? It is called as a primary endosperm nucleus. Okay, primary endosperm nucleus. It is triploid. Means how that nucleus is formed there? Just after fusion of the second male gamete with the two haploid polar nuclei, there is a formation of the triploid primary endosperm nucleus. So from that, student, triploid primary endosperm nucleus, there is a formation of endosperm. Okay, so in angiosperm there are the three different types of the endosperm. That is, the first one, it is the nuclear endosperm. Second type of endosperm, it is the cellular endosperm, and the third type of endosperm, it is the helobial type of endosperm. So let's see those endosperm one by one. So the development of endosperm in angiosperm. So see, the development of endosperm. Okay, development of endosperm. No doubt, student, there are the three types of endosperm. The first one, it is the nuclear endosperm. Okay, nuclear endosperm. Okay, the second type of endosperm, it is cellular endosperm. Okay, cellular endosperm. And the third type of endosperm, it is helobial endosperm. Okay, so see, the first type of endosperm, it is the nuclear endosperm. So how this nuclear endosperm, it is developed, this part we are going to study. Remember, student, such a type of the nuclear endosperm, okay, this nuclear, so see, the first one, the nuclear endosperm. Okay, nuclear endosperm development. Remember, this nuclear endosperm development, it is seen in case of the few members. So what are those members? It is seen in case of sunflower, wheat and coconut. So it is seen in case of the sunflower. Okay, student, sunflower. It is also seen in case of the wheat and the very typical and typical development. It is seen in case of the coconut. Okay, coconut. So in these members, it's this type of the nuclear endosperm, it is seen. So remember, this nuclear endosperm, it is not observed everywhere in all the angiospermic plant, but it is reported or it is given in our textbook near about the 100, okay, 161 the angiospermic families. Okay, near about the 164 the angiospermic families, they show a such a type of nuclear endosperm. So what is that nuclear endosperm, student? Here, suppose this is the what is this? This is the embryo sac of the fertilized ovule. Okay, this is the embryo sac. So here, suppose where to say this is the developed zygote. Okay, this is the zygote. Okay, this is the zygote. The ploidy is 2n, and this is initial. Okay, this is the initial, the PEN, okay, primary endosperm nucleus, and this primary endosperm nucleus, it is triploid, okay, it is triploid. Then in this primary endosperm nucleus, remember from this primary endosperm nucleus, what is developed? There is a beginning of development of endosperm, okay. So remember, student, from this zygote, what is going to develop from this zygote? The embryo is developed. So we have studied in previous lecture how embryo is developed. But remember, there I was mentioned the one statement while studying the embryo development. At what time the embryo development begins? When there is a sufficient development of, or when there is a sufficient developed endosperm, then the embryo development begins. Okay, so for the development of embryo, what is required, student? The endosperm. It is required because the endosperm, it acts as a food material. Okay, they provide the nourishment to the developing embryo. So with respect to that, so see, this is the primary endosperm nucleus. Inside that primary endosperm nucleus, what is takes place? The free nuclear division takes place. And all this division, it is mitotic. Okay, all these divisions are mitotic. What is the free nuclear division, student? Here in this division, there is a division of the nucleus and the cytoplasm. They never divide. So such a type of free nuclear division we have studied at the time of the embryo sac development. So that type of the free nuclear division. Then when there is a free nuclear division, what happens, student? So these are the few developmental changes in the zygote. Okay, there is a few division in the zygotic cell. Okay, there is a few division in the zygotic cell. We also at this we are not concerned with what happened in the embryonal development. Only we are concerned with the development of endosperm. So what happened here? When there is a free nuclear division inside this primary endosperm nucleus, which are triploid. There is first the appearance of this central vacuole. Okay, there is the appearance of the central vacuole. So this is the vacuole, student, and the divided nuclei, they are arranged peripherally. Okay, divided nuclei, they are arranged peripherally. So all the nuclei, they are arranged all along its peripheral side. So this nuclei, they are arranged peripherally. Okay, they are arranged peripherally. So peripherally, all along its peripheral side, that nuclei, they get arranged when there is a development of the vacuole at the center. Okay, then in the next step of this such a type of the nuclear endosperm development, the wall formation, it takes place from the periphery toward the center. Okay, wall formation, it is takes place from the periphery toward the center. There is a few development in the embryonal cells. Okay, so we are not concerned with that development. And the wall formation, okay, so all these are the peripheral nuclei. Okay, these are the peripheral nuclei. So the wall formation, it is takes place from the peripheral side. Okay, so remember this one, like this way, there is a wall formation from periphery toward the center. So like this way, the wall formation, it is takes place all along its peripheral side. Means the first layer of cell is formed in the second layer. So this is the second layer. So such a type of the wall formation, it is takes place from the periphery toward the center. So remember, in this the nuclear endosperm, finally that endosperm, it becomes cellular from periphery toward the center. Okay, so the wall formation, it is takes place from from periphery towards the center. Okay, periphery toward the center. Then finally, what happens, student? That endosperm, the entire endosperm, they become cellular. Okay, So this is a few endosperm. This is the embryonal development. And what we observe here, finally, all the endosperm, it becomes cellular. Okay, so this is very simple. This is the development of the endosperm. So finally, all endosperm becomes cellular. So student, this is the nuclear endosperm development in case of angiosperm. Remember, such a type of endosperm development, it is seen in case of the sunflower, in case of the wheat, and it is reported in the wheat, in the coconut. Okay, so remember, student, in case of coconut, it shows the typical characteristic feature, in the sense, in the coconut, student, आपण जे खोबरं खातो ते खोबरं जे आहे की ज्याला आपण कोकोनटचा एडिबल पार्ट म्हणतो, दॅट एडिबल पार्ट, इट इज द आउटर मल्टी सेल्युलर एंडोस्पर्म. ओके, आउटर मल्टी सेल्युलर एंडोस्पर्म, ऑर दॅट एंडोस्पर्म इट बिकम्स सेल्युलर. अँड देन जे नारळामध्ये पाणी असतं, ओके, नारळामध्ये पाणी असतं, दॅट कोकोनट वॉटर, इट इज अ फ्री न्यूक्लिअर एंडोस्पर्म, मीन्स ऑल द न्यूक्लिया दे आर फ्रीली सस्पेंडेड दॅर. ओके, अँड रिमेंबर वन मोर कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर इन दॅट कोकोनट, इट शोज द सेंट्रल व्हॅक्युअल. म्हणजे नारळामध्ये जे एडिबल पार्ट, की ज्याला आपण खोबरं असं म्हणतो, तो मल्टी सेल्युलर एंडोस्पर्म आहे. त्याच्यानंतर नारळामधलं पाणी जे असतं, तो जो एंडोस्पर्म आहे, तो फ्री न्यूक्लिअर एंडोस्पर्म आहे, कारण त्याच्यामध्ये न्यूक्लिया फ्रीली सस्पेंडेड असतात. आणि नारळामध्ये जी पोकळी असते मध्ये, त्याला आपण व्हॅक्युअल असं म्हणतो. सो इट शोज द आउटर मल्टी सेल्युलर एंडोस्पर्म सेंट्रली प्लस फ्री न्यूक्लिअर एंडोस्पर्म, अँड अगेन ॲट द सेंटर दे शोज द व्हॅक्युअल. सो स्टुडंट, दिस इज the nuclear endosperm development in case of the angiosperm. So now immediately we move toward the next part, that is the cellular endosperm. So the next type of the endosperm development, it is the cellular endosperm. Okay, cellular endosperm. So the second one, it is the cellular. We have studied the first. So second one, it is a cellular endosperm. So see, the cellular, okay, cellular endosperm development. So this cellular endosperm development, it is seen in case of Adoxa. Okay, example ADOXA, Adoxa. Then it is also seen in case of Petunia. Okay, Petunia plant. Such type of the cellular endosperm, it is seen. Or remember, it is also seen in case of the balsam. Balsam yala marathi mele apan tela terda asa manto, terda madhe hi endosperm development aplyala pahayla milte. So what is this endosperm development? As usual, the first step, as it is. Okay, here is the zygote, here is the primary endosperm nucleus, and it is followed by the next division. Okay, it is followed by the next division. So what is that division, student? Here in this, there is no free nuclear division. Okay, there is no free nuclear division. So instead of this free nuclear division, okay, there is no free nuclear division in the cellular endosperm right from beginning. That endosperm, it becomes cellular. Okay, it becomes cellular. So the first division in this primary endosperm nucleus, it is the karyokinesis karyokinesis, it is immediately followed by this cytokinesis. Karyokinesis, it is immediately followed by the cytokinesis, and finally there is a formation of the endosperm. It is the cellular endosperm. So there is a formation of the cellular endosperm. So this is in short the cellular endosperm development in case of Adoxa, in case of the Petunia, and in case of the Balsam. Okay, in case of the Balsam, what happened here? The name itself indicates cellular endosperm. Cellular means right from beginning, from the primary endosperm nucleus, first primary endosperm nucleus, there is a formation of the two cells. Then from the two, there is a formation of the four cells. From the four, there is a formation of the 8, 16, 32, like this way. That endosperm, right from beginning, it becomes cellular. And finally, so this primary endosperm nucleus, it is immediately followed by the karyokinesis and cytokinesis, and all the divisions. All these are the mitotic, okay, mitotic divisions. And there is a formation of the finally such a type of the cellular endosperm. I think, student, you understand well such a type of the endosperm development in case of Adoxa, Balsam, and the Petunia. This endosperm, it is called as a cellular endosperm. Then the third type of endosperm, it is the helobial endosperm. Okay, third one, it is the helobial. Okay, helobial endosperm. Okay, student, helobial endosperm. This helobial endosperm, okay, so we have studied the first, second, and now the third. This helobial endosperm, it is seen in, okay, this endosperm, it is seen in the order helobi of the monocot. So it is seen in order helobi. Okay, order helobi of the monocot. Okay, student, it is seen in order helobi of the monocot. And remember, this endosperm development, it is seen in case of, example, it is seen in case of Aspodilus. Okay, it is so it is seen in case of the Aspodilus. Okay, Aspodilus, it is from the order helobi of the monocot. Okay, in this, the helobial endosperm development, it is seen. So how that endosperm, it is developed, or what are the developmental process? So remember, this helobial endosperm development, it is intermediate between the first, the nuclear endosperm, and the second one, it is the cellular endosperm. So how that development, it is seen in case of the endosperm. See what happened. This is the initial stage. Okay, in the initial stage, then in this, the first division takes place. In this primary endosperm nucleus, the central cell which is having the primary endosperm nucleus, they divides by the first division, and that division, it is karyokinesis. Okay, karyokinesis, it is followed by the cytokinesis, and there is a formation of the two unequal size cells. Okay, there is a formation of the two unequal size cells. So this is the few embryonal developmental stages. Okay, as usual, and there is a formation of here because of this division. This is the mitotic division, student. This is, as usual, this is the mitotic division. So there is a formation of the two unequal size cells. So the smaller cell, it is present towards the chalaza, and the larger microphyllar cell. So this is the smaller, okay, this is the smaller chalazal cell, and here it is a larger microphyllar cell. Okay, it is a larger microphyllar cell. Then remember, the next division in this, The next division in the both the cell, okay, next division in the both the cell, it is free nuclear, okay, free nuclear divisions. In both the cell, it is free nuclear division. But remember, student, how it is a free nuclear division? How it is a free nuclear division? See, or where it is actually the maximum free nuclear division and minimum free nuclear division. Remember, in this case, the upper larger microfilar cell, okay, upper larger microfilar cell, they show the maximum division, and this lower chalazal smaller cell, they show the free nuclear division, but that nuclear divisions are very few, or sometimes in some members, this smaller chalazal cell, they never divide further. Okay, they never divide further. So in this, there is a free nuclear division. Okay, maximum free nuclear division, it is seen in the micropylar cell. Okay, larger micropylar cell. So how it shows? It shows a cystic structure. There is a few free nuclear division toward the lower smaller chalazal cell, and there is a the maximum free nuclear division in this upper cell. Okay, in this upper cell. And remember, student, all the nuclei, divided nuclei, they are arranged peripherally. Okay, all these divided nuclei, they are arranged peripherally. So like this way, there is a continuous free nuclear division. So remember, as like this cellular endosperm, it shows the first division, the karyokinesis, it is followed by the cytokinesis. Okay, and as like the nuclear endosperm, it shows the free nuclear division. Okay, it shows the free nuclear division. So because of a two types of division, which are seen in previous two types of endosperm development, the endosperm, halobial type of endosperm development, it comes intermediate between the nuclear endosperm and cellular endosperm. So finally, as usual, in the upper larger microfilar cell, the wall formation, it is expressed from from periphery toward the center. Okay, from periphery toward the center. And finally, remember, the entire endosperm, they start to become cellular, but that cell formation, it is takes place from periphery toward the center. So finally, what we observed a such type of the endosperm, that is the all endosperm, finally it becomes the cellular. Okay, it becomes cellular, and only the lower side, it shows the few cells. Okay, it shows the few cells, and or sometimes that lower smaller chalazal cell, they never divide further. So student, here remember, we have studied the three types of the endosperm development. So student, now we will move toward the next event, from the post fertilization changes. The next one, it is the development of seed. Okay, there is a development of seed. Okay, development of seed. So in angiosperm, you know that student, from which part of the carpel the seed is developed, or from which part of that pistil or that female reproductive part the seed is developed. What is student that? The ovule. So from the ovule, after fertilization, seed it is developed. Means the ovule is converted into seed. So remember, the ovule, it is converted. Okay, after fertilization, the ovule, it is converted into seed. Okay, ovule, it is converted into seed. So it is takes place after fertilization. The ovule, it is converted into seed. Remember, student, the seeds, they are of two types. So two types of seeds. Okay, two types of seeds. The first type, we have to say, the endospermic seed. Okay, endospermic seed. And the second type, it is the non-endospermic. okay, non-endosed permic seed. So the two types of seeds are formed in case of angiosperm, means not in all individual member. So some member produce the such type of endospermic seed and some produce the non-endospermic seed. So see, what happens to them, just I will give the information. The integument of ovule, it is converted into seed coat. Okay, so outer integument of ovule, converted into outermost protective covering of seed coat, that is called as a testa, and inner integument of the ovule, it is converted into innermost layer of seed coat, it is called as a tegmen. So testa and tegmen together, it is called as a seed coat. Okay, it is called as a seed coat. Then as usual, the centrally placed, mass of ovule, means inside the integument, what is situated, the nucellus is situated. So remember, the in the mature seed, that nucellus, they are remain in the form of the thin membranous layer. That thin membranous layer, it is developed around the endosperm. So that membranous layer, it is called as the perisperm. Okay, perisperm. And then this next to the nucellus, what is present? The embryo sac is present there. So from that embryo sac, there is a formation of the embryo. Okay, because the zygote is there, that zygote that divides and redivides, and what is formed, the embryo is developed. But remember that growing embryo, they utilize the food material from the endosperm. Okay, endosperm. Then what happened? When that embryo, they utilize the endosperm entirely. म्हणजे वाढणाऱ्या एम्ब्रियोने जर एंडोस्पर्म हा कम्प्लीटली युटिलाइज केला, तर अशा बियांमध्ये एंडोस्पर्म शिल्लक राहत नाही, तर त्या बियांना आपण काय म्हणतो, एंडोस्पर्म नसलेल्या बिया, किंवा आपण त्याला नॉन एंडोस्पर्मिक सीड असं म्हणतो, किंवा त्याला दुसरं नाव आहे एक्स अल्ब्युमिनस सीड. परंतु अशा बिया कुठल्या आहेत, तर तुम्हाला माहित आहे शेंगदाणा, वाटाणा, हरभरा, म्हणजे सगळे जे कडधान्य आहेत, त्या कडधान्यामध्ये आपल्याला ह्या नॉन एंडोस्पर्मिक सीड दिसतात. फॉर एक्झाम्पल स्टुडंट, तुम्ही शेंगदाणा किंवा वाटाणा उघडून बघितलेला असेल, सीड कोट रिमूव्ह केलं की काय दिसतं तुम्हाला, आतमध्ये दोन डाळी दिसतात आणि रॅडिकल आणि प्लिम्युल दिसतात, दुसरं काही दिसत नाही, म्हणजे हे एंडोस्पर्मिक सीड आहे. पण सॉरी, दिस इज अ नॉन एंडोस्पर्मिक सीड. अँड एंडोस्पर्मिक सीड मध्ये काय होतं की तो एम्ब्रियो जो असतो, तो एम्ब्रियो हा एंडोस्पर्म कम्प्लीटली युटिलाइज करत नाही, तो पार्शियली युटिलाइज करतो. त्याच्यामुळे तिथे मॅच्युअर सीड मध्ये एंडोस्पर्म देखील दिसतो आणि एम्ब्रियोच्या बरोबर तिथे एंडोस्पर्म दिसतो, पण इथे पार्शियली त्याने एंडोस्पर्म युटिलाइज केल्यामुळे एम्ब्रियो हा एंडोस्पर्मिक सीड मध्ये एम्ब्रियो हा आकाराने लहान असतो. एम्ब्रियो कसा असतो, आकाराने लहान असतो, कारण तिथे त्याने एंडोस्पर्म कम्प्लीटली युटिलाइज केलेला नसतो आणि त्या बियांमध्ये एंडोस्पर्म तसाच तिथे असतो, तसाच काही प्रमाणात युटिलाइज केलेला असतो आणि मॅक्सिमम अमाऊंट मध्ये तो तिथेच असतो. तर त्याला आपण एंडोस्पर्मिक सीड असं म्हणतो, किंवा आपण त्याला अल्ब्युमिनस सीड असं म्हणतो. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, तिथे एंडोस्पर्मिक सीडचं एक्झाम्पल की तुमच्या ह्या टेक्स्टबुक मध्ये मेज सीड दिलेलं आहे, मेज असेल किंवा मग कॅस्टर सीड. आपण एरंडाचं जे तेल काढतो ते एंडोस्पर्म पासून काढतो, म्हणजे कॅस्टर सीड इट इज द बेस्ट एक्झाम्पल ऑफ द एंडोस्पर्मिक सीड, हे लक्षात घ्या. सो नाउ हियर वी आर टू ड्रॉ द डायग्राम्स ऑफ बोथ द एंडोस्पर्मिक अँड नॉन एंडोस्पर्मिक सीड. सो फर्स्ट सी, एज पर युअर सिलेबस, द मेज सीड, ओके, इज द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ एंडोस्पर्मिक सीड. सो सी द फर्स्ट द एंडोस्पर्मिक सीड एक्झाम्पल, इट इज मेज. ओके, मेज. सो इन द मेज, यू आर अवेअर विथ स्टुडंट, इन द मेज सीड इट शोज ए सच टाइप ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, इट शोज ए सच टाइप ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर. सो इन द मेज, दिस इज द this maize, actually maize seed, it is not a seed, it is a fruit. It is a caryopsis type of fruit. Okay, it is a caryopsis type of fruit. So in this caryopsis type of fruit, the ori wall and seed coat, they fuse to form a hard, tough and thick covering. It is called as hull. So this is the hull, means outermost hard, tough covering of that maize seed. It is called as hull. It is followed by the one cell thick layer of cell. Okay, that layer of cell, it is called as a aleurone layer. Okay, one cell thick layer of cell. So remember, all this one cell thick layer of cell, it is called as the aleurone layer. So what is the function of this aleurone layer, student? This aleurone layer, during seed germination, they release the amylase enzyme, and that amylase enzyme, it is utilized for the conversion of this starchy endosperm into monomer. Okay, into monomer. Then this is the entire place. So this is the aleurone layer. Aleurone layer. Okay. Then this is actually the endosperm. Okay, this is the endosperm. Then this endosperm and the embryo, it is separated by the one layer. Okay, one layer, and that layer, it is called as the epithelial layer. Okay, this is the epithelial layer. What is the significance of this epithelial layer? So this is the epithelial layer. Epithelial layer. Okay, this is the epithelial layer. This epithelial layer, they only separate the endosperm from the embryo. So what is that embryo? Here it shows, this is the radical. You are aware with the structure of monocot embryo, and this is the plumule. Okay, so student, this is the radical. Okay, radical. As usual, this is plumule. Okay, this is the plumule. Then the outermost covering of radical, okay, thin membranous sheath, it is called as a polyorhizome. Okay, it is a polyorhizome, and the outermost thin membranous covering of this plumule, it is called as a polyptile. Okay, this is the polyptile. Then this entire structure, student, this the radical plumule, or the radical and polyorhiza and the plumule and polyptile, it is covered by the single cotyledon, and that cotyledon, it is shield shaped, and that cotyledon, it is called as scutellum. Okay, that cotyledon, it is called as scutellum. So shield shaped cotyledon, it is called as this scutellum. So such a type of the seed, this is the best example of endospermic seed. It is seen in monocot example maize. Okay, so the maize, jawar, bajra, wheat, all these are the examples of the endospermic seed. So now we see the another type of seed where the endosperm is not there. That seed, it is called as the non-endospermic seed. Okay, non-endospermic seed. So say the non-endospermic. Okay, non-endospermic seed. So what is that non-endospermic seed? The pea seed. Okay, pea seed. So what they show, student, in the non-endospermic seed, they show only the seed coats. Okay, these are the seed coats. As usual, this is the seed coat. Okay, these are the seed coat, and then these are the two cotyledons. Okay, these are the two cotyledons. So these are the cotyledons. So endosperm is totally absent. So it is a non-endospermic seed. And then what it shows? It shows the structure, such a type of the structure. Okay, it shows a such a type of the structure inside. Okay, here is also a such type of the structure they show. Okay, and what is the structure? This is, student, this is the epicuti. okay, epicotyle region. Then this is the student hypocotyle region. Okay, hypocotyle region, and as usual, this is the radical. Okay, this is the radical. So system of this structure, it is seen the epicotyle region, hypocotyle region. So what is developed from this epicotyle region? Further, the plumule and the plumule, it is developed. Okay, plumule it is developed, and this hypocotyle, and there is a development of the radical. So here, I think you understand well. There is no the presence of endosperm inside seed. So that endosperm, so that seed, it is called as a non-endospermic seed. This example, it is P seed. So remember, comparatively, you see, when that seed, embryo of seed, when they absorb the endosperm totally, the size of the embryo increases. And when in case of the endospermic seed, when that the embryo of seed, when that they utilize the endosperm partially, there the size of the embryo is highly reduced. So here we are completed the how the seeds are developed in case of angiosperm, and what are the two types of the seeds and their parts. Student, now we are to study the fourth event of the post-fertilization changes, that is the development of fruit. So from where the fruit is developed, which part of the female reproductive organ they take part in the development of fruit? The ovary, they take part. Okay, means ovary, after fertilization, it is converted into fruit. So remember student, here as per your syllabus, we have to study the simple fruit. Okay, simple fruit. So that simple fruit, it is directly developed from that the ovary. So ovary, it is converted into the fruit. So wall of ovary, it is converted into the fruit wall. Okay, wall of ovary, it is converted into fruit wall. And as usual, the entire ovary, it is converted into the fruit. So for example, the example of simple fruit, it is the mango. So in that mango, it shows the three parts of that fruit, not a three parts, but these are the three parts of the fruit wall. The outermost leathery part, it is called as epicarp. Okay, then the middle flesh portion, it is called as the mesocarp. And the centrally placed hard and stony, it is an endocarp. So these are the epicarp, mesocarp, and endocarp. These are the three wall of fruit which are developed from the wall of ovary, and it is called as the pericarp. Okay, so these are the pericarp. Okay, these are the pericarp. So the wall of fruit, it is developed from the wall of ovary, it is called as a pericarp. And inside that pericarp, see student, there is a placement of the seed. And the seed, you know that seed, in case of mango, it is a the non-endospermic seed. It is not having the endosperm inside. Only what they have, the cotyledon, plumule, and radical. So with this student, we are completed the post fertilization changes. In that, what we have studied, the development of embryo, it is followed by the development of endosperm. Then we have studied how the ovule is converted into seed, means what are the parts of ovule, that parts of ovule, it is converted into what type of the parts of seed, that also we are seeing. And in this, we have studied how the ovary is converted into fruit, in the sense, the ovary wall, how it is converted into the wall of fruit. So we have completed here the entire process of fertilization in case of angiosperm, means what happened before fertilization and what happened after fertilization. So with this student, we will stop at this moment.